Parashat Nitzavim. I spoke last week about the two prongs in terms of the return of the Jewish people. The first return will be the return to the land of Israel. The second return will be the return to the God of Israel and his laws and commandments. How come that is the order? I would think that it would be easier for there to have been a mass return to Torah, because there were many Jews who were religious throughout the diaspora. They would not have remained faithful Jews, and even with the sobriquet of Jew, had they not been faithful to the Jewish traditions. Those who were not faithful to the Jewish traditions in the diaspora disappeared from Judaism. So wouldn't it have made more sense for them to have returned within the diaspora, because moving from country to country is hardly simple for any individual, a very difficult process. Wouldn't it have been easier to begin with the mitzvot like Shabbat, Pesach, and then the second stage, coming to Israel? And let me explain, because I think this is a very important point. Judaism is a nationality first. We became a nationality when we became a family with a special and specific mission to bring blessing to the world through morality and peace. We began as a nation, a family writ large, a family extended into many, many families with very key and creating and creative forefathers and foremothers. After we became an extended family and a nationality, then came Ma'amad Har Sinai, many, many years later, when we received God's Torah and we became a religion. But the sense of nationality must come first. The sense that I'm a separate people, tied to all human beings by Tzelem Elokim, the image of God which is within all of us, but with family traditions and customs, and a mission that we must bring to the world of peace and morality. We began with a nation. If you'll think back, that's exactly what Ruth says to her mother-in-law Naomi, one of the most important of all the converts. She says to her mother-in-law, who was a deeply religious Jewish woman, Amech Ami, your nation shall be my nation, Elokaich Elokai, and only afterwards your God will be my God. She begins by moving to Israel together with her mother-in-law. And the religion became deepened and emboldened once she lived in Israel. I want you to understand, it's almost impossible, certainly very difficult, to truly remain Jewish in a foreign land with a foreign culture. Because the foreign land and the foreign culture is usually very much inviting and alluring. In our own land, it's much easier to be Jewish. So it begins with the peoplehood, with the nationality, with the family writ large. That's the first step. And that's why, although it is a difficult step, that's what has to come first. And when we make the move from the diaspora, where we have always lost the majority of our people, 7/9 of the Jews in America, as I am speaking to you this morning, are involved in an intermarriage without any real act of conversion. So it begins with getting out of the diaspora. And then we are able to really get back to God. That's what the Bible prophesizes. That's what we are experiencing today. And thank God, we have the great glory of seeing many, many Jews returning and returning to Israel and returning to God, and especially after returning to Israel, deeply returning to God. Only one more very brief point. You understand now perhaps why so many of the early Zionists were not the religionists. The Zionists were returning back to Israel in order to find their culture. The religionists felt they had their culture. They didn't understand how difficult continuating that culture in a foreign country will always be. History has proven that. Sociology has proven that. So we are very grateful to the Jews who came to Israel in the beginning. We are grateful to the Zionists, who may not be as punctilious about religion as the non-Zionist religionists are, but ultimately they formed the future, which is Jewish eternity, because it's only in Israel where we have a secure and strong future. Shabbat Shalom.